It's Britney, bitch.
Britney Spears, pop icon. The star has been in the limelight since the late 90s, selling millions of records, and is known for using sex and controversy to cement her stardom. The controversy surrounding her always kept her in the headlines, from dramatic performances to scandalous relationships and an infamous breakdown. It leaves many questioning. Why? Although this is alleged, as personality disorders come with a social stigma so they won't be discussed publicly, looking at the criteria of what is histrionic personality disorder, or HPD for short, it is easy to see that this is likely what Britney Spears is suffering from. Before we get into the criteria of why I think she suffers from HPD, let's talk about what that disorder is. HPD is a Cluster B personality disorder, which is the same group as narcissistic personality disorder, antisocial personality disorder, and borderline personality disorder. They cannot be labeled as somatoform or dissociative, as they do not fall into either category. A dictionary definition of HPD is a pervasive pattern of excessive emotionality and attention-seeking. What causes HPD? Well, the actual cause is unknown, as there has been limited research and disagreement on whether it is environmental, genetic, or both. We do know that Britney began displaying the signs of HPD at a young age. Born in Macomb, Mississippi in 1981, she always loved being the center of attention, in an interview admitting, "Ever since I was 7 or 8, my mom would have company over and I was always performing for everybody in front of the TV," end quote. She also started her career at 11 in the all-new Mickey Mouse Club TV show. So, from a young age, Britney enjoyed being the center of attention, but that is not what HPD is all about. HPD has a list of criteria that describe common traits of someone suffering HPD, which include the following. Being uncomfortable when they are not the center of attention, over-sexualized and provocative behavior, using physical appearance to draw attention to oneself, style of speech that is excessively impressionistic, exaggerated display of emotion and self-dramatization, consider relationships to be far more intimate than they are, and make rash decisions. It is actually believed that several people in Hollywood suffer from HPD, as their whole job is being the center of attention, and Britney Spears is no different. She would always perform in an over-the-top way, trying to do something new and bigger and better each and every time she went on stage. This would cause a lot of people to talk about her, and everything she did eventually became newsworthy, to the point where simple things such as having a night out would be front page newsworthy. And it got to the point where a lot of the things that she was doing was solely for attention. Britney Spears is well known to use sex in her performance, everyday life, and her lyrics. While we don't slut-shame in this household, she had the tendency to make out with her female counterparts on stage despite not being gay, to start controversy. And who could forget the countless times she would forget to wear underwear, and then go where the paparazzi is, where her crotch would be fully exposed. Her lyrics tended to be about sex, but we will get into that more later when we discuss the way her disorder affected her art. Her outfits tended to follow the rule, less is more, and by less, I mean public indecency and borderline naked. Here are a few examples. Some of these are from performances, but some, like the following four photos, I just pulled off the mother of two's Instagram. That one of her in the bikini didn't even have her face in it. No shade to being proud of your body and how you look, but it definitely has gathered the attention of her 17.8 million Instagram followers and fulfills the criteria of using your physical appearance to draw attention to yourself. At the point when she definitely used her physical appearance to draw the most attention to herself was when she shaved her head in 2007. As we all remember that photo very well. There was a period of time where Britney Spears had this whole shtick where she would fake a British accent. Some believe this was a sign of multiple personality disorder, but it actually also fits the criteria for HPD, which is beginning to sound like an STD the more I say it. Here are some clips of her with her British accent.
No restroom.
No restroom.
Put it down.
You hold it.
All right, thank you.
Excuse me.
Can you open the restroom, please?
Can you open the restroom, please?
Sir. You, right there.
Hello, manager.
You work here.
Can you open the restroom?
Emergency.
Yeah, but you're making a mess of this.
Yeah, open the restroom.
Oh my God, it stinks in here.
Who farted?
Oh my Lord. I don't know.
She also had the tendency to cry in interviews. Britney Spears would also consider relationships to be more intimate than they actually were. Like, she got married for 55 hours, she had 15 relationships since Justin Timberlake in early 2000s, including two marriages, and she would always claim that each guy was the one. Britney Spears would also make rash decisions before thinking, like the time she stole a lighter from a gas station for $1.39 and then immediately went outside and told paparazzi that she stole something, the time she shaved her head, and the time that she also attacked paparazzi with an umbrella. She would drive around with her child in her lap. It would seem that Britney Spears would make a lot of decisions impulsively and without thinking. Since HPD usually sets in before early adulthood, Britney Spears doesn't have a period of time where she was psychologically healthy. However, an examination of her lyrics show more signs that she has been suffering from this disease for a long time. Some of the best examples are found on my favorite album of hers, Blackout. This album was released at the same time as her mental breakdowns and her entrance into psychiatric wards, so the lyrics are particularly revealing. Piece of Me is about the media's love of her and how she loves the attention. The lyrics are directed at the paparazzi, and I selected the song because it definitely fits the attention-seeking criteria that is the main concept of HPD. Drama, guess I can't see the harm in working and being a mom and with a kid on my arm. Give Me More talks about being the center of attention while also giving hints that this is a sexual encounter. The lyrics, "Cameras are flashing," refers to the paparazzi's interest in her and reveals that this is partly why she does it. Talking about sex and being the center of attention is two criteria of HPD and is why I selected this song. Slumber Party is from her most recent album, Glory, but it also follows the same themes throughout her other music. This song, like Give Me More, also heavily goes on sex, but also mentions cameras again, showing that she does like the attention. Her disorder caused all of these themes to be prevalent throughout all of her music, from her first album in the 90s to the album that came out in 2016. Her disorder manifested in her work, but it also made her one of the most successful pop stars in history. Thank you.